the most important skills for many of our industrial positions is the ability to read a ruler. Many people have learned this skill, but if you haven't used a ruler in a while, you might be a little rusty. This video is intended to refresh some of the skills you might be asked when taking a ruler test at a company, and also measure some common materials at your job site. Many employers need you to read a common tape measure. Here's an exploded view of increments within 1 inch. The longer marks at each number represent 1 inch, and remember that 12 inches equals 1 foot. The next longest lines between an inch are a half inch. The next longest lines between there are a quarter of an inch. You'll see here that this ruler has 32 marks between each inch. This will allow you to measure up to a 32nd of an inch. In this ruler, this has 16 marks between each inch. That'll allow you to measure up to a 16th of an inch. If your ruler has 8 marks between each inch, that ruler measures up to an 1/8 of an inch. So it's important to know which measurement of ruler you're using. If you're using a 32nd of an inch ruler, for instance on the top line, and you measure off 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, this is 7/32 of an inch. However, if your ruler is a 16th of an inch, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, this is 7/16 of an inch. So on a tape measure, there's other colored numbers that represent certain things. If you're in construction or carpentry, on a tape measure, you're gonna see a red number every 16 inches. This will represent studs within a wall, and studs are every 16 inches. So every 16 is colored red, 16 and 32. You're also gonna see, after you reach 1 foot, 12 inches, that another red number shows up on top, and that's inches after a foot. So 12 inches is 1 foot, the red number after that is 1, so this is 1 foot, 1 inch. And again, 1 foot, 2 inches. So now as practice, let's just measure some common things around our office. So here we have a box of paper clips. The length is typically referred to as the longer side of your object, and the shorter side usually is the width. So I'll measure the length first. And here, we see that we're at 3 inches and almost to 4. And so we have quarters. 1/4, 2/4, 3/4. So this is 3 3/4 inches. Now for the width, we go across. And we're at 1 inch, 2 inch, and 1/4. So 2 1/4 inches. So next we just have some Post-it notes. And across, we're right at 3 inches. And it's perfectly square, it looks like. And we're also at 3 inches. Okay, so we have a mouse pad here. Let's measure that. And going across. And there, it looks like we have 7 3/4 inches. And we'll go across this way. And it looks like this one comes up just short of a half an inch. So we're using a 16th of an inch ruler. So if we count 7, and then the number of 16 tally marks up until here, that gives us 7 7/16 of an inch. Okay, now we'll measure a CD case. And the width, pretty standard, so we have 5 inches. The length, we go across, and it looks like it falls just after a half of an inch. So let's try to figure out what that one is. So it's 5, and again, if you count up the different 16 tallies, it falls 1/16 tally after a half. So that's 5 9/16. Okay, and then finally we have a box. So the width of this box is 3, and our tally marks here, if we count up the 16ths, we have 3 10/16. Now when that happens, when you have two numbers that are divisible by 2, we can go down to eighths. So it's actually 3 5/8. So here's the eighths. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The length of it then is 7 2/16. Again, 2 16 are both divisible by 2. So that can be dropped down to 7 1/8. Well, that sums up how to read a tape measure and measuring some common objects. Hopefully that helped you and that'll help in your next job or job interview. If you have any questions, feel free to direct them at a QPS recruiter. Thanks.